Hi everyone, welcome back. I'm glad that you were able to join me this morning. Okay, so for fun, as our warm-up, I have some more animal analogies. Remember, an analogy is sort of like a comparison. And I'm sorry, when I made this bigger just now, I can see it is a little blurry. So I apologize, but I will read you each analogy and also the words in the word box so that you're able to hear it in case you can't see these analogies. Okay, so up top, in our word bank, we have frog, barn, cave, kitten, cheetah, meow, honey, bunny, sea, and mouse. Okay, so again, an analogy is like a comparison. We did this, I think, in our first week. So, like, polar bear is to white as koala is to gray, okay? A polar bear is white and a koala bear is gray. So you're just comparing the physical features of the color of their fur, okay? So I'll give you number one, and then we can work through 2 through 10 together. So number one is B is to hive. All right. So bees live in the hive. They work on their honey in the hive. As bear is to, where would a bear hang out? Now I know some of you may be thinking forest. That is true. That is not a choice in our word bank, however. So out of the words along our word bank, what would be a good choice? Good. If you said cave, you are correct. So we can cross that off of our list. Okay. Slow is to snail as fast is to, So I know that a snail is slow. So here we're comparing the speeds of two animals. So a snail is slow, but what animal in our word bank here is fast? Which word could we fill in the blank for number two with? Frog? Cheetah, kitten, bunny, or mouse. Those are our animals in our word bank. Which animal is pretty fast on that list? Okay, if you said cheetah, you are correct. Very, very fast animal. All right, cows are to milk as bees are to, So cows produce milk. We can actually milk cows from their udders. So what do bees help to make and produce? Cows are to milk. As bees are to, which word in our word box here would help us to complete sentence three or analogy three? All right, if you said honey, you are correct. We know bees like working in the hive to make their honey. Number four, sheep is to lamb as rabbit is to, okay, so a baby lamb, or I'm sorry, a baby sheep is called a lamb, so a baby rabbit is called a what? Good. If you said bunny, you are correct. Number five, our next analogy. Monkey is to banana as cat is to... So monkeys enjoy eating bananas. What do cats chase? What do they like to chase and capture? Only a few choices left, but if you said mouse, you are correct. All right, number six. Caterpillar is to butterfly as tadpole is to, thinking about the life cycle of these insects and animals here. So before a butterfly becomes a butterfly, it is a caterpillar. So a tadpole turns into a what? If you said frog, you are correct. All right, number seven, winding down here, four left. Okay, bird is to sky as fish is to, so birds fly in the sky, they live on trees which reach high in the sky, and fish, of course, we know can't live out of water. So bird is to sky as fish is to... If you said C, you are correct. All right, three more. Horse is to foal as cat is to... So a foal is a baby horse, and a baby cat is called a... Kitten, great job. Chicken is to coop as cow is to... So chickens typically stay in a coop or a pen. That's considered a coop. So a cow usually stays in a where? To get milked and to get its food. In a barn. Great job. And our last one, dog is to bark. My little corgi puppy loves to bark at everything that passes by. So I'm familiar with this. And cats like to meow. That is their way of communicating. All right, nice job. I hope you had some fun with our second round of animal analogies. Here we go, guys. We're going to move on with something new this week. And this week, we are going to talk about determining the theme. Theme of a fable. Interesting word, fable, through details in the text. So what that means is we're going to take a look at some different passages, read through the text, and determine the theme or the moral of the story. And we'll take a look and refresh our memories as to what a fable is. All right, so what is a fable? A fable is a very short story. It teaches a moral or a practical lesson about how to succeed in life. It started as an early form of storytelling. So they're made up stories, but they do have good lessons. The morals of the stories teach us something valuable. They were believed to have been originated in India. A lot of fables feature animals, plants, and forces of nature with human characteristics, meaning the animals can talk to each other, they can go outside, they live in houses, they do things that they normally couldn't do on their own, and they're given human characteristics, things that humans can do that animals typically cannot independently do. And it's a story told by word of mouth from generation to generation. We'll take a look at fables in a little bit more detail. Some you may have read and you haven't maybe realized that they're a fable. So, what is a fable again? It is a type of folktale that ends with a lesson. So, our theme is the moral of the story or the lesson. The characters are always animals and are able to talk and have human-like behaviors. Again, they talk to one another, they do things that us humans do that animals typically cannot do. Some characteristics of fables, how we know what a fable is. Only 2 to 3 characters. The characters talk. The setting is usually outside. Fables are very short stories. They're not long, lengthy paragraphs. They're not chapter books. They're just short stories. Ooh, there is an element of trickery included. So sometimes one character may try to trick another character. And the lesson or moral will be stated at the end. Okay, so here's where our theme is. The lesson or the moral of the story. Here's where we identify theme. Okay, so you may be wondering, why are we learning about this? Why do authors write fables? Well, fables are written to entertain their readers, okay? They're fun, silly stories, but they also have a message. So additionally, all fables have a lesson in them, so authors might be trying to persuade their readers to act a certain way based on the lesson in the fable. Interesting. And some examples that you may have read or you may have heard of include Country Mouse and City Mouse, one of my favorites, The Tortoise and the Hare, another classic, The Wolf in Sheep's Clothing, and The Goose Who Laid the Golden Egg. All examples of fables. Again, I'll leave this up for another 30 seconds or so in case you're taking notes on what a fable is, since we'll be looking at fables today. Remember, we're identifying theme, and theme is the lesson or the moral of the fable. Okay, so again, theme is the moral of the story, the main message. What the author wants you to learn or know, a broad idea about life, so usually a life lesson, and it's usually not stated, it must be inferred. Well, this is perfect because we talked about inferences, So I know that you guys are great at inferencing. So we can use our inferencing skills to determine the theme of the story. And remember, theme is just the moral of the story. All right, so some common themes just to give you an idea as we're going through some of these fables, we may come across some themes of acceptance. All right, a theme of acceptance means that these stories have characters that accept and respect the differences and beliefs of others. Preparedness. These stories have characters that avoid trouble by being prepared and ready for any situation. Another common theme would be courage. These stories have characters that are brave enough to overcome a fearful or difficult situation or accept a challenge. So they're courageous, they're brave. Kindness. These stories have characters that are friendly, generous, and considerate of others' feelings. Cooperation. These stories have characters that work together to complete a task or reach a goal. Right. Moving on to the other side. Resourcefulness. These stories have characters that find clever ways to solve their problems. Compassion. These stories have characters that care for and help those who are suffering. Perseverance. These stories have characters that keep trying and never give up, even when things do not work out at first. Honesty. These stories have characters that learn that it is best to always tell the truth. Very good moral of a story to include honesty. And another common theme is friendship. These stories have characters that trust one another and remain loyal throughout the story. So if you'd like to just take some notes or take another 30 seconds to, again, look at the different common themes. These are all themes that could be found in these fables. Okay, let's continue and see if we can identify some of these themes in our fables. So I will do the first one for you. I will read it aloud and show you how I would identify the theme or the message of this fable. So our fable is called The Crow and the Pitcher. Many years ago, a crow, nearly dead with thirst, came upon a pitcher which had once been filled with water. When the crow put his beak into the narrow mouth of the pitcher, he found that, sadly, there was very little water left in it, and he could not reach down far enough to get it. He tried and he tried, but at last he had to give up in despair. Then a thought came to him. He flew to the ground, grabbed a pebble with his beak, and dropped it into the pitcher. He noticed that the water level rose a bit when he dropped the pebble. So he took another pebble and dropped it into the pitcher. Then he took another pebble and dropped it into the pitcher. Then he took another pebble and dropped it into the pitcher. Then he took another pebble and dropped it into the pitcher. At last, he saw the water mount up near him at the top of the pitcher. After tossing a few more pebbles in, he was able to quench his thirst and save his own life. Okay, so what is the theme or message of this fable? Well, one thing I would do is I read through the passage once. I could go back and reread it to myself for more clarification. I know that there was a pitcher of water. It had once been filled with water. There was very little water left. So he had to find a way or a strategy to raise the water level so that he could drink it. So he took a pebble, dropped it. He noticed the water level increased. He took another, dropped it. The water level's increasing. So he was finally able to quench his thirst and save his own life. So I would say that a good moral of this story, we can go back to our common themes, is perseverance. Because in stories that have perseverance as a theme, the characters keep trying and never give up. Okay, so he had to continue to try. The first time he dropped the pebble, the water didn't raise high enough for him to be able to drink it, but he noticed that it rose slightly. So he continued to persevere until that water level increased for him to drink. So just for you as a reference, there are many different graphic organizers that can help you organize your thoughts. So one way to help you find the theme is to think about how did the characters react to the obstacles. So in our example here, the character didn't give up. The bird did not give up. He continued to persevere by dropping the pebble into the pitcher. What important decisions did the characters make? Something to think about. Here, this crow knew that he needed water because he needed to quench his thirst. So again, he persevered and did not give up until that water level rose. How did the characters grow or change in the story? Well, our crow did not rely on anyone else to save his life. He took it upon himself to quench his own thirst and save his own life. And we can say, what did the characters learn? Well, this crow learned by persevering, he was able to raise the water level and to not give up because he was able to save himself. Okay, so this is just a nice little tool, a graphic organizer that you can use when trying to organize your thoughts and to try to determine what the theme is in any passage. Okay, so we have a few more Aesop's fables. Each fable has a moral or lesson about life. So, the first few, the moral is given to us, but we can answer some questions to go along with the fable. The first one I have is called The Travelers and the Plane Tree. Two travelers, worn out by the heat of the summer's sun, laid themselves down at noon under the wide spreading branches of a plane tree. As they rested under its shade, one of the travelers said to the other, "What a singularly useless tree is the plane! It bears no fruit and is not of the least service to man." The plane tree, interrupting him, said, "You ungrateful fellows, do you, while receiving benefits from me and resting under my shade, dare to describe me as useless and unprofitable?" Okay, so although the tree was not providing fruit, it was providing shade for the travelers. So our moral is that we tend to be unappreciative of what we do have when we focus on what we don't have. So we can say that it's best to be grateful. Okay, sure, it didn't bear fruit, but it did provide shade, and it was a hot summer day, and the travelers needed shade. So they should have been grateful that the tree was providing shade. So in what way are the travelers ungrateful? They're ungrateful because they didn't appreciate the tree's shade. Explain what the moral means in your own words. Okay, basically we talked about being grateful, appreciating the things that we do have, and not focusing on what we don't have. All right, and take 30 seconds to think of an example of something you or someone you know should be more grateful for. So oftentimes we get so caught up in things that we want or think that we need, that we often forget that we should be grateful for the things we do have. Okay, very good. So let's move on. I'll read for you The Donkey and the Lapdog, and then I'll have you think about explaining the moral in your own words. A man had a donkey and a Maltese lapdog, a very great beauty. The donkey was left in a stable and had plenty of oats and hay to eat, just as any other donkey would. In return, the donkey had much work to do grinding corn at the mill and carrying heavy loads from the field. The lapdog was well cared for by his master, who petted him, played with him, and seldom went out to dine without bringing him home some tidbit to eat. The donkey often compared his arduous life with the luxurious idle life of the dog, and he became discontented with his lot, thinking that he could behave like the dog, so he too could enjoy the same privileges. He broke his cords and halter and galloped into his master's house, kicking up his heels and being frisky. Next, he tried to jump on his master's lap, as he had seen the lapdog do, but he broke the table, and smashed all the dishes upon it to atoms. Then he attempted to lick his master and jump upon his back. The servants, hearing the strange hubbub and perceiving that their master was in danger, quickly relieved him and drove out the donkey to his stable with clubs. The donkey, as he returned to his stall, beaten nearly to death, lamented, "I have brought it all on myself. Why could I not have been contented to accept my natural position as I labor with my companions instead of trying to be idle all day like that useless little lapdog?" So we could say that the moral here, or the theme, is be satisfied with your lot instead of desiring a lot that doesn't really suit you anyway. Okay, so what they're basically saying is be satisfied with what you have, with who you are, and don't try to be someone or something else. Okay, the man enjoyed the donkey for what the donkey could provide, and the man enjoyed his lapdog for what his lapdog could provide. So two very different animals, and it's okay to be different. All right, we have the crab and the fox. I'll let you do this one independently. I'll read it to you, and then you can answer questions A and B. A crab, forsaking the seashore, chose a neighboring green meadow as its feeding ground. A fox came across him, and being very hungry, planned to eat him up. Just as he was on the point of being eaten, the crab said, "I well deserve my fate, for what business had I on the land, when by my nature and habits I am only adapted for the sea?" So the moral is being content with one's lot brings happiness. Being discontent with one's lot brings unhappiness. Okay, so think about how this story is similar to the donkey and the lapdog that we just read. And in your opinion, should one always be content with one's lot? Meaning, should you always just be content with who you are and what you have to offer in your situation and not envy anyone else? That's what that means. Okay, so take some time, either self-reflect on A and B. You can write down your responses, or if somebody is with you at home, parent, guardian, sibling, whoever it is, if you'd like to share out your thoughts for A and B, please take the next minute or so to do so. Okay, so how is the story similar Be content with who you are and what you have to offer. Don't be jealous or envious of anyone else. And in your own opinion, should one always be content with being who you are? I would definitely say yes. I would agree. Okay, so that is all of the time that we have for today. We will continue discussing theme in tomorrow's lesson. So just as a way to wrap up, I want you to think about what is theme and how can we recognize the theme in a story. So take a minute, reflect. Thank you for joining me today, and I look forward to meeting with you tomorrow. All right, guys, thanks for coming. Have a great day. See you tomorrow.